l'idée de nature est-elle naturelle? Est-ce que toutes les sociétés du monde
ont the idea of nature natural? Are all societies in the world involved with the same idea of nature? This is what we're going to discuss now. Plants and animals appeared on the surface of the earth long before the human species. Therefore, they can be considered as natural. They have an intrinsic existence that owes nothing to man. This forest also is made of oaks that date back to long before man appeared on earth. But the structure of the forest is due to man's activities because he cuts down trees and plants new trees. These landscapes are also the result of action carried out by innumerable generations of farmers. They introduce species, move them, and shape the ecosystem. For farmers, the spaces are natural. But for ecologists, who are only interested remotely, these spaces are almost artificial. For an ethno-ecologist, these spaces, which will be called agro-ecosystem, are the topic on which he works on a daily basis. In a community, different players have different perceptions, different ways of understanding the natural space. Painters have shown us how they see landscapes. If you compare here a German painting and a Japanese painting, almost painted at the same time, they really show the place occupied by man versus nature. On the left-hand side, the man dominates the nature. On the right-hand side, the man is integrated in nature. The various societies across the world have a different vision of nature. The question was asked a long time ago. Man has always been wondering whether climate has influenced human societies. More recently, geographers have placed the basis of the reflection. Paul Villal de la Bâche asks himself, what is given to us by ecology, or Max Sorg, who worries about the idea of a man's ecology. But regarding ethnology, American anthropologists made the decisive contribution when they examined the relationship between various types of societies in their ecosystem, each with their own technique and production mode. The American anthropologist Conkling worked in the Philippines, and he coined the word ethno-ecology, referring to a way of analyzing societies, taking into consideration their practice, their thoughts, their vocabulary, and classifications. In France, in the Museum of Natural History, agronomers and botanists developed ethnobotanics because they thought that the relationship between man and plants really is about the relationship between men themselves. Jacques Barrault worked on the ecology developed by Conklin and worked on research of human societies and their practices, taking into consideration the knowledge they have on the natural environment. In parallel, at the Collège de France, the man who invented structural anthropology, Claude Lévi-Strauss, disseminated the idea of the science of concrete, which characterizes oral tradition societies, and his successor, Descola, developed an anthropology of nature, which analyzes discontinuities between man and all the other living beings, trying to emphasize the main trains of thought which are common throughout humanity and representing the relationship between man and the surrounding environment. We therefore see that each human society has its own conception of nature. First of all, nature and environment are interpreted, thought, and give rise to representations. This is the object for environmental anthropology, but at the same time, ordinary biodiversity, which is really what supports the existence of human societies, is the subject of research in the ethno-ecological field of science, studying nature as it is thought and experienced by human societies.